Advent service under our theme of prepare, believe, rejoice. Our theme this evening is rejoice. And our gathering hymn is number 257, O come, Emmanuel. We will sing verses 1, 4, and 5.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
that rejoicing in your salvation, we may bring forth the fruits of repentance through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God. Prepare, believe, rejoice. Faith overflows into abounding joy as God fulfills his word of promise. New life created by God's own life-giving breath is stirring in the virginal womb of the lowly Virgin of Nazareth. She who has responded in faith to the angel Gabriel's message. Her heart is filled with joy, and her feet cannot. Her joy is a joy that must be shared with someone. With whom shall she share this joy? Who among her friends and neighbors would believe her story? What will Joseph, her intended husband, have to say? Eventually, he will have to be told. But for now, she tells him only that she intends to travel down to Judea to spend some time with her cousin Elizabeth. What better person could there be with whom to share this joy? After all, Elizabeth knew something about the wonder-working power of God. She, at that very moment, was experiencing that power in her own body. She, who was thought to be barren and past the time of childbearing, has now conceived a child. And so Mary perhaps attaches herself to a caravan that is traveling south in the direction of Jerusalem, a journey of about 70 miles, taking at least
likewise filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaims with a loud cry, "Blessed are you, Mary, among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, the new life growing within you." And why has this come to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb jumped up and down for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord. And now, Mary has an opportunity to express her own great joy in that song of praise which down through the centuries has come to be known as the Magnificat. Magnificat anima mea dominum, when it's translated into Latin. My soul magnifies the Lord. And my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. Mary proclaims the greatness of the Lord in words and imagery that show how much she was immersed in the Old Testament scriptures of her people. She declares her joy not only for what was God is going to do, but for the miracle that has already begun to take place in her, for the new life that is already stirring in the deepest recesses of her own body. She rejoices in the one whom she declares as God, her Savior. For in view of what her child is to accomplish, she rejoices in the prospect of a human race redeemed from oppression, sin, and corruption. She rejoices that God is lifting up the lowly, for he has lifted her up. She rejoices that God is filling the hungry with good things, even as the rich and proud are emptied of their pride. She rejoices that the time has come for God to make good on his promises to Abraham and to all the people of Israel. She rejoices and sings out her joy not only for Elizabeth, but for future generations to hear. Not long hence, Elizabeth's time of special joy will come as she gives birth to the infant John. And the father, Zechariah, will share the joy. He who had been struck dumb and had not spoken a word for 9 months, his tongue will be set loose in praise and thanksgiving to God for the long-awaited For we do have a God who lifts up the lowly and the bowed down. A God who in Mary's child, Jesus, lifts us up to high places. Calling to mind the words of the prophet Habakkuk, though the fig tree do not blossom and there be no fruit on the vine, though the produce of the olive fail and the fields yield no food, though the flock be cut off from the fold and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will exalt in the God of my salvation. God the Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer and makes me tread upon the heights. In the same spirit, we might recollect what Paul wrote to the Thessalonians. Rejoice always. Pray constantly. Give thanks in all circumstances. For this
can we live in safety.
Keep our nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving help among all nations.
Let not the needy be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in me a clean heart, O God.
And renew a right spirit within me.
Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come before you.
O Lord our God, you have commanded the light to shine out of darkness, and you have again brought us to your house of prayer to praise your goodness and ask for your gifts. Accept now in your endless mercy the sacrifice of our worship and thanksgiving, and grant us those requests which will be wholesome for us. Make us to be children of the light and of the day and heirs of your everlasting inheritance. Remember, O Lord, according to the multitude of your mercies, your whole church, all who joined with us in prayer, our sisters, all our sisters and brothers, wherever they may be in your vast kingdom, who stand in need of your help and comfort. We pause to raise any special prayers that are on our hearts and minds. Allow for silence. We pray for our sister Felicia, pray for all our members confined to either their homes or to nursing homes or places of rehabilitation. We raise to you all the needs of this suffering world, especially those whose lives have been devastated by storms. Pour upon all of them the riches of your mercy, so that we, redeemed in soul and body and steadfast in faith, may ever praise your wonderful and holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity.